Well, definitely. I think, if you look at the wicket which we are playing on right now, it's not even 15% of what we're going to get in the game. So we understand that. There's no point wasting 2 days, guys going in, scoring quick 15s and coming out. We'd rather have them do two sessions like today, get into the test match zone, test ourselves. We can try and prepare the wickets the way we want to. But if you're playing a two-day game, there's no room for, changing the wicket at different times of the day. So here we have the freedom to, just put more water on the wicket, roll it, make it harder, come tomorrow's practice session, and then, we have conditions that we want. So you're never sure of, whether you're going to get quality practice games or not. So we would rather have practice sessions that are in our control, the way we want to run them. And then, it doesn't matter whether you play three practice games. If you're not in the right kind of frame of mind, then it doesn't matter starting, on 5th of Jan. Whether you played two practice games or three, if you're in a good headspace and you have practice sessions, I feel that's good enough as well.
Well, all I'll say is this team is up for the challenge. In fact, if you asked me 4 years ago whether it was up for the challenge, I would have said no. But this team's gained an experience now. And like Virat mentioned, you've got bench strength in your fast bowling department, which is the key in taking 20 wickets in the places you mentioned.
Well, I think the most important thing is not to get surprised by the pace and bounce. We have convinced ourselves that it is going to be much quicker and much more bouncier than back home, and you're going to get balls that may surprise you every now and then. So the most important thing is to just put it in the past, put it behind you, and focus on the next ball. That's something that we did last time as well. I think you can't afford to think that there's too much pace and bounce. You rather take it on, believe in your abilities, and take it head on. I think that's key to playing in conditions that are different from your own.
See, like we mentioned, for us, every game is a home game. Even this is a home game at Newlands. You see the pitch, you adapt. No excuses, no complaints. Two teams have to play on that surface. If tomorrow you go to England, it might be seaming all over the place. You come to India, it might be turning. So, it's not a question of, if you want to be rated as a side, you adapt to those conditions. It's as simple as that. Leave all the other crap aside. Just get out there and try and compete in those conditions, whatever is on offer.
The kind of bowling attack we have now and the kind of balance we have in the side, we definitely believe that we can win here. There's no two ways about it. If we wouldn't have that mindset, there's no point of getting onto that flight as well. So we have come here wanting to express ourselves, believing in our abilities, knowing that we have the right balance to win test matches in any conditions that we play at. This one again is an opportunity for us to play good cricket. We're not thinking about whether we're playing in South Africa or any other country. For us, it's about winning sessions, being in the present, executing our skills well, not looking at the history as to what has happened in a particular country where we play at. You might have a great record in a country, but again, as I said, if you're not well prepared, it doesn't matter, you're going to end up losing. So I think international cricket is all about staying in the present and trying to do the things better than your opposition at all times during any of the games that you play.